is reality.
Well, dreams, they feel real while we're in them, right? It's only when we wake up that we realize something is actually strange.
Welcome, everybody. It's Q-Code, the podcast. This is a bonus episode. By now, you've pretty much figured out what
bonus.
Bonus. And that is...
the dream intro is what you're talking about.
The dream. Super stoked about this one, guys. This is dream number 4. And Danny...
Who was that that just talked in a weird voice?
Was it me?
No, I think he's talking.
Oh, about, I was like, did I?
Where's
talk
Danny?
Did I talk
he's
in a weird
talking
voice?
About me? This is Batman's.
That no,
Batman's more like this.
Yours like
I'm Batman. I can't even go that. I mean, this is Batman.
If that's how Batman so, talked, I would not. I mean, it totally makes sense why the Joker's constantly laughing.
Anyway, for anyone who doesn't notice, I'm feeling fine. I just have partial voice now. I want to say I have no voice, but I have some voice now. But yeah.
Do you have a cool story to go with it? Like you went to a concert, an awesome rock concert, or is it like...
No, I was in a concert singing at the top of my lungs for 14 straight hours. And this is what happened.
Okay. I don't even know what to say. I'm sitting there trying to think. I'm like, all right, what can I make fun of you for?
Literally took what I said and made it the least cool thing you possibly could.
But no, so I will do my best to get through. But if this is the first episode somehow that you're listening to, this is not my real voice. My real voice is much, much cooler.
Yeah. So... yeah, I mean, again, yes, if this is your first time.
Hang on, I just got to say, you sound exactly like, and this isn't breaking HIPAA at all. I work at an ER, but I'm not going to name names. We did have the other night a meth addict come in completely tweaking, and then she crashed. And when she woke up, she would just like, she scared the crap out of me. Literally. Like, she acted like a zombie, but in fast motion, like the way she walked. I don't know, but her voice was almost exactly like that. Like, just pops up behind my desk, like, excuse me, can I have some water? I'd be like, ah!
You're like, ah, here's some ice chips! Eat it!
Because I work the night shift sometimes. And we turn off the, we like turn down the lights. Like, I don't know, it's just a tradition we have.
Because and that's so- what's supposed to happen in hospitals, right? You've seen every single horror movie that's happened
exactly.
In a hospital. And what happens?
They just
turn the lights off for some reason. Like, there's nobody
that's
there.
That's true. Why?
It's but so anyways. That these murderers can walk around and freely kill everybody.
Yeah. But so yeah, it's even scary. It was even scarier because it's all herd. It's like it's not super dark. I mean, we have like some lights on, but you know, we dim it. And my desk literally like is right across from the psych room / drunk tank rooms or whatever. And so like she just silently walked up, and I'd be like looking on the computer, and she'd pop up right behind it, and be like, "Can I have some water?"
Yeah, that would probably.
Do you have a blanket?
Excuse me, sir. Who told you to get out of bed?
Just sitting there, and all of a sudden you just hear, 1, 2, buckle my shoe.
It's like,
whoa! Get in the room now!
Let me tell you, though.
Who let you out of that straitjacket?
So we have, like, security cameras that are right at my desk. Like, I have a monitor that I can see the people that are in the psych/ drunk tank rooms. Because we have to be able to monitor them in case they're, like, you know, suicidal. But occasionally, if you accidentally hit the wrong button, it, like, jumps back to, like, your previewing, like, previous whatever. It's because you're watching the recording. And occasionally, it scared me because we've had somebody in there. And then, like, somehow I accidentally click on the recording and, like, they're just disappeared in the room. I was like, what? And then I look over and they're, like, right there. I'm like, ah! Oh yeah, okay.
Do they ever just look at the camera and just start walking up to it?
That would scare me. That would scare me.
Well, this dream number, volume number 4, I don't think it is not a scary dream. It is an adventure.
That's a good word for
possibly
it.
An underwater adventure. It's a very interesting tale. So just gonna get right to it. I don't know how long. It's like 4 pages. So shouldn't take us too long to get through, unless there's a lot of things for us to make fun of.
Which I don't see how. These are very, very tight-knit, foolproof stories.
And we have read these before, but I can tell you, it's been so long since since we've read this one, I cannot remember much about it. So I'm excited to see.
Yeah, me neither.
What happens. So here we go. Starting in to the dream. Dream Short Series, Volume 4. The Curious Case of the Bad Batch of Bananas. That just is a fun... That's a fun title.
I have to say, I enjoyed coming up with that title. I was like, what could be...
You know, and I don't remember what the bananas have anything to do with, but...
Me neither.
From what I recall, they have very little to do. But we'll see.
Well, because I just, like... You have the curious George and monkeys, they like bananas, so.
That's why I put them together.
Yeah.
The Curious Case of the Bad Batch of Bananas.
But you know what monkeys do not like? Bad bananas.
Yes. All right, here we go. I pull up to the house feeling excited because A, I got off work early, and B, because I had a softball game to play in. Why I'm so excited about the softball game, I'm not sure. But I really feel like we have a good team this year and can go deep into the postseason.
You don't get a good team every year. You got to capitalize on the times you do.
Now, remember, this is a dream, but apparently... This is a team that Danny has been a part of for years. And he just knows this.
I've been building this team for a while.
He has
making strategic trades.
Like, hey.
Picking up free agents.
Like, hey, Jason, I'm sorry. You're not good enough, man. You're cut. It's tried, like, but I paid my dues.
We tried putting you in left field last year. We all know how that ended.
Isn't it right field?
Well, I don't.
There's really a left and right field.
Yeah.
Well, I know that. I'm just saying, like, where you would stick the sucky people because it's the place where the least balls go.
We put you in right field.
Well, unless there's a bunch of left-handers.
Okay.
You were obviously more interested in the bumblebee on the dandelion than you were on catching the ball, and we lost the game.
All right. We can go deep into the postseason. That is, if there is a postseason. Plus, this is the 4th game of the season. How many times are you going to say season?
That's a good word.
4th game of the season. But I had to miss game 2 and 3 because of work obligations. Anyway, I get home and the family begins preparations to...
Does your work not realize how much time and effort you have put into this team and they make you miss games 2 and 3?
2 and 3.
Jeez.
I have now, up to this point, missed 2/3 of the season after all this hard work.
I get home.
And aren't you the boss at work in your own dream?
Yes. Why can't you just say, hey guys, I'm going whether you want me to or not?
I don't know. I didn't actually like live that
like,
part of
I can our team is really good. Like, we can go to the postseason. Like, deep into the postseason. I mean, as far as rec softball can go, we're going there. We picked up a really good pitcher this year.
Like, I'm pretty sure we'll play full 2 weeks beyond the regular season.
I get home, and the family begins preparations to head to the park for the game. As we're packing up the car, I feel the hunger pangs. Is it pangs? I feel like we had this conversation last time. Isn't it pains?
No,
it's pangs. Hunger pains.
It's hunger pangs. That's actually what it is.
Like you have pains.
Yeah,
your stomach.
You're hungry and you hurt.
Did you look this up?
You looked it up when we read it the first time. You're like, oh, it is hunger pains.
I just don't believe it. I looked it up, but I don't believe it.
So when you're a kid, or do you get growing pangs?
Yeah.
Because that whole show is just completely wrong.
It only goes with hunger. You can't. Other things are pains, but with hunger, it's pangs.
Like, I'm starving to death. Yeah, but it's not real pain. It's just pangs. So,
see? What is hunger pang? These are commonly known as hunger pangs. Hunger pangs or hunger pains are caused by strong contractions of the stomach when it's empty.
Okay.
Pain.
That's a stupid word, but
yeah,
I feel the hunger pangs swelling in my abdomen. Why can't you just say stomach? My abdomen. For all of you human biology majors. I look around the kitchen for something to quickly snack on and see that the wife has purchased a new bunch of bananas. Now, just so everybody knows, you have no idea where this dream is going. You think right now it's just this innocent, like, I'm hungry, I'm going to eat a banana. You just wait. I decide that would be a perfect pregame treat and pull one out of the stock.
Because you need the potassium for, you know, your muscles to be able to function in a game.
And it's supposed to be off the stock, not out of the stock.
One off the stock.
But I know I spelled it wrong.
I swiftly pulled back the banana peel and bite into my healthy goodie. It's at that moment that I felt like something wasn't right. I could feel the texture of something I wasn't expecting in my mouth. I quickly pulled the banana back to examine what it was I was feeling. As I tore apart the banana, I realized that there was a piece of hemp strung. Hemp strung right between the banana itself. Slightly grossed out.
Wait, I don't get it. A hemp?
Like it's like a piece of string.
Hemp string?
Yeah, it was like a hemp string. And it was like...
right in the middle of the banana?
Right in the middle of the banana. Just like... like
the banana grew around a string of hemp.
Yes.
As I recall, I believe he tries to explain it.
Oh, okay.
As I tore apart the banana, I realized that there was a piece of hemp strung right through the banana itself. Slightly grossed out, I tossed the banana in the trash and yelled to the wife, "There was a piece of hemp in my banana!" Oh, and I just... it could be anything but hemp.
Sometimes when you got something gross,
this is,
you got to tell
this people. This is what it. He dreams. Like, oh. Oh. There is hemp in my banana.
Yeah, why?
Why?
It couldn't just be regular old string. It had to be hemp.
Couldn't it be something that's actually disgusting?
That's
like
true.
A finger.
Well, when you're not expecting it, hemp is disgusting.
I guess.
Like kind of with like all the squishy banana around it, it just makes it all like gross. And, like it's got like little fuzzy hairs on it and stuff.
Okay. A few moments later, we were in the car heading to the park for my long-awaited softball game. On the way there, the wife pulls out the remaining portion of the bunch of bananas. And asks if I'd like to eat one while I drive.
Damn it, why did you bring those? Did you not hear what I said earlier?
Not the hemp bananas.
I want my bananas hemp free.
I remember, I am still a bit hungry, so I take her up on the offer.
What an idiot.
What's the chance? Have you ever had hemp in your banana?
Again.
What's the chances of it happening twice?
But the thing is, he's probably, this is him in his head.
Hey guys.
He's like, Oh, go ahead. No, there was hemp in my last one, but I am still hungry. Yes, I will take you up on that offer.
Okay, this is the perfect sound for what just happened.
Fool me once. Shame on you. If fool me, we can't get fooled again.
A fool man can't get fooled again.
I take her up on the offer for the banana.
I'm still a bit hungry, so I take her up on the offer. She hands me a banana and I begin to peel and eat it while on the road. As I'm slowly consuming the yellow fruit, again, I feel something unnatural in my mouth. I reach in and pull out what can only be described as a gold bracelet chain. Not again, I say. I look down at what's left of the banana and see that there are various random objects poking out. I start pulling the objects out one by one. When I'm finished, I'm left with one bracelet chain, two necklaces, and a steel ring inside a Ziploc baggie.
I mean, it's too good to throw away.
Hang on. Like, I know bananas grow on trees, but it's like somehow it makes me think like there was a dead body involved as fertilizer. Somehow all this guy's jewelry is obviously, I don't know, a mobster with a gold chain. And
yeah, as before, it was just like, yeah, it was some hemp, but I'd say like you hit the jackpot on this banana.
Yeah.
So I
can you believe these bananas were on sale?
At this we point, totally made our money back.
At this point, I would say, screw the softball game. Where'd you buy these? We got to go now
get
and get some the rest.
More bananas. Think, honey, we might find one with a diamond in it.
We're leveling up each time.
I look toward my wife and say, what is wrong with these bananas? They're full of junk.
What? Junk. I would love that. Junk.
I don't know. Sorry, Liz. I don't know. I just bought them at Costco. Well, I think that these bananas have been grown. Is this the one that is like the longest sentence ever? Okay, hold on. Okay. Well, I think that these bananas have been grown in an area that has been war-torn for a long time now. And perhaps many of the random objects that are being blown up and strung about are ending up in the soil where the bananas grow and are picked up by the trees over time and deposited into the bananas before they are harvested and shipped to Costco.
I was kind of right with my theory of the dead body.
That's probably it. That is literally the only logical explanation. I mean, I'm not saying that there are any logical explanations for this, but that is definitely the only one, right?
But, I mean, the dream before, I was a detective. So obviously, I brought some of that in
into the next dream.
Where I use my detective skills to deduce that there obviously was some kind of war-torn country that was trying to grow bananas to try and make some money so that they could continue to support the war efforts. But there's so many bombs going off that things were getting splattered everywhere within the soil they were trying to grow the bananas in at the same time. And it ended up in my bananas.
But I feel like this war-torn country had to be in the Caribbean and your pirate treasure was just being blown up everywhere. Because there's gold chains, rings.
Well, then how unlucky was I that my first banana was only hemp?
Gar. I can see pirates using hemp rope. Get me one of those bananas with the gold.
At this point, we pull up to the park. I no longer feel very hungry after the banana experience. So I start pulling my softball gear out of the trunk to get ready for the game. I then realize that we are early and have some time to kill before the game starts. The family and I look up and see that the park is holding some type of movie in the park event and decide to head over there until it's time for the game.
Was it like a movie on a projector? How they do that, you know?
They like put up a like a screen, and then they project a movie for you to enjoy with your family for free.
We lay on a blanket on the ground under a tree next to the pond and wait for the movie to start. I then hear a voice coming from the pond. This is where it turns. This is where it completely changes. I look over and there is a girl in the water, head out and arms on the bank. She looks at me and asks if I can help her. Sure, I say. What do you need help with? Literally no thought whatsoever. Just, I'm here waiting to watch a movie, killing some time before my softball game. There's some chick in the pond who needs some help.
Hey, at least I asked her
No, you didn't.
I said, yeah. What do you need help with?
Oh, I guess yes, you did. But you just answered, sure. Sure. I would ask, what? Why? Like, what do you need help with?
Well, normally if somebody's in a body of water and they're saying asking for help, it's like an urgent, I'm drowning, help. Please help. But in this, it's just like, excuse me, sir. Would you mind helping me?
He's just quick to say, like, yes. Before, I guess that's my only issue with this. He says, before he even asks any questions, he's like, yeah. Was it? Yeah, I'll help. What do you need help with?
Were it a guy, would you have responded in the same way?
What? Sorry, I was reading.
I said, were it a guy, would he have responded in the same way?
I don't know.
Excuse me, sir. Can I get some help? I'll let you know next time I have this dream, but with a guy. What I do?
I really want to watch the movie in the park, but my raft is stuck at the bottom of the pond. I need help getting it to the surface so that I can float in it while watching the movie.
That's the only way to really enjoy a movie in the park.
Okay, I'll help you. What do you need me to do? Follow me, she says. She then dives into the pond and starts swimming toward the bottom. I jump. Just all right. Here I go. I jump in after her and start making my way toward the bottom of the pond as well. As I swim deeper and deeper, I can see some sort of bubble structure built on the base of the pond. The girl swims into an entrance on the bubble and I follow. Once inside the enclosure, it's a nice, quaint, cozy place. It kind of makes me think... kind of makes me think of what it would be like inside of a beaver's home.
Sometimes a picture is worth a thousand words, right? I didn't want to spend a thousand words describing every nook and cranny of this place, so the best thing I can think of is...
like a beaver's home.
I was thinking more like...
most people know that, right?
What is it? I was thinking more like SpongeBob SquarePants. Is it a cat? Or no, what is it?
It's a squirrel.
A squirrel. Where she,
Sandy. You
know, Sandy, yeah. Her house has to have like air, right?
She's kind of in a bubble thing, but
because for some reason she's a squirrel that lives underneath the freaking ocean.
Yeah. She chose poorly.
Hey, the square pants should have been the first clue that things weren't correct in this world.
He's a sponge, he's supposed to be square.
But this was much like not as grandiose as her home in SpongeBob was. This is like a little smaller and more compact.
I just want to know how the raft got down there. Okay.
You and me both.
Okay. Where is this raft you want to get to the surface? Just then, I hear other voices. I look up and see a small dwarf-sized man and a giant 8-foot-tall, 600-plus-pound man.
600-plus?
Yeah, he's massive.
Jeez, even at 8 feet, that's... No.
Speaking of, my daughter has been obsessed lately with My 600-Pound Life. Because my wife watches that once in a while, and now she'll request. I'm like, hey, what do you want to watch, London? I want to watch My 600-Pound Life. Like, why? She's like, I love the surgery part. I'm like, you're going to be a doctor, aren't you? She's like, probably.
Probably. And yeah,
I have no idea what that show is. What is that?
It's just about 600-pound people
way over 600 pounds.
And how their journey of not being that 600 pounds anymore.
It always starts with them at the beginning, and it kind of shows like their bad habits, and like they tell kind of like maybe how they got there, but then they go visit this doctor and he's like, if you can lose 100 pounds in like the next 2 months, then I'll take you on and do the surgery, like the like cut out part of the stomach,
like a gastric bypass, whatever. Yeah.
And then some of them make it and some of them don't. Well, I mean, not like die, but I'm saying like
some of them live and some of them die.
But like some
that is very riveting TV, I can tell you.
Some of them like make the like lose the 100 pounds and can get the surgery, and others like you can tell usually from the get-go though, just by like them talking, like if they're really gonna make it or not. Cause some people are just like, I really wanna lose weight, as they're like eating like a Snickers.
What is I don't get it. Like, wouldn't the people who really just can't on their own be the ones that should be getting the surgery over the ones that can lose 100 pounds on their own?
Well, they have to show that they can't, because it'll be a waste of a surgery if they can't show that they can.
The surgery makes it impossible for you to eat that much. No, because
your stomach can expand to this, like, it basically shrinks your stomach because they cut out like a whole chunk of it.
So basically what you're doing is you're training yourself to eat the normal amount instead of sitting in your bed with a freaking frying pan cooking up fried chicken. So anyway, so there's a dwarf-sized man and a giant 8-foot-tall, 600-pound man. They are sitting inside of an inflatable white water raft-looking thing. Are you here to help us get the raft to the... I don't know why this is there. Are you here to help us get the raft to the surface? One of them asks. Why, yes, I am. What seems to be the problem? I respond.
I think they just stated it.
Every time we try and get the raft to the surface, it just sinks. Let's give it a try. The four of us all drag the raft to the entrance of the enclosure and push it out into the bottom of the pond. Immediately, I watch as the raft begins to float towards the surface. The three of them all pile into the raft, and it suddenly starts to sink again. I can't really speak as I'm holding my breath underwater, but I can see what the problem is. I swim up and push the huge man out of the raft. I push the huge man out of the raft, at which point the raft continues its ascent toward the surface. I tug on the big man, and he and I follow the raft up to the water's surface. When we all arrive at the surface,
can you not just be like,
I just realized I wrote surface a lot.
You go on the streets. You fall in love with one word for a paragraph, and you're like, have not used it enough.
When we all,
but couldn't you just be like, hey guys, I understand you love being in the raft. But just until we get it to the surface, nobody get in the raft, okay? Just
actually, you 600-pound man, you cannot be in the raft ever. Ever. I'm assuming that that's how it got down there in the first place. When we all arrive at the surface, the dwarf and the girl are ecstatic that the raft is now floating on top of the pond and they can now watch the movie. The big guy, somewhat frustrated, asked me, why did you push me out of the raft? I explained to him that the reason the raft couldn't float to the surface was that he was too heavy and was weighing it down, and that if he wanted to watch the movie in the park, he was going to have to watch it from the edge of the pond, as the raft could not stay afloat if he were in it. Nah.
Sometimes you just gotta be blunt.
Why did you push me out of the raft? It's science, man. It's pure science. You are too heavy for a thing that cannot hold your weight.
You see, your weight has to be dispersed over a surface area, and the surface area that the boat has on the bottom on the water is not large enough to disperse the weight that you have.
I like the way I said it first.
Just kidding. So therefore, you either need to A, lose some weight, or B, buy a bigger raft.
Does it have to do with surface area? I thought it was just all density.
My density is pop me.
Like a raft, it's super, super low density because it's filled with air, right? So well, yeah, then when you add a person, it has nothing to do with surface area. It's you add a huge guy and he adds to the density of the raft by a lot.
No, but you have to
disperse. And then it becomes more dense than water.
I know, but you have to disperse the weight. That's why, like, you can't just float on your finger in the water, but you can float if you put, like, your arms out and your back and everything.
No, that's because you're, oh, well, you're technically your finger then is super dense compared to, because only your finger's
man,
in the water.
Both of you are
and
super
it's carrying
dense.
The entire 100-something pounds of your body, so your finger counts as a super dense
I
thing.
I really shouldn't have said, I don't know why I don't
fine,
learn.
I guess surface area.
I never learn. I no. should not say the word science.
Hang on, I understand now. Surface area it is directly correlated to volume, which is correlated to density, yes. I guess. Okay. Okay.
And we are continue. Now all smarter for having listened to that. He quickly realized that what I had said
hey, Travis,
was... Hey, yeah.
Travis. Is this how you talk to your teachers in high school?
Oh, heck no. I didn't talk at all. Because I didn't know anything they were saying. There were no questions. Because that's the thing. It's like the teacher would be like, okay, well, if you have questions, answer now or ask me now. And it's like, man, I don't even know what questions to ask. Literally have no clue what you just talked about.
In English, what situations would I use a question mark?
Okay. So he quickly realized that what I had said was true and agreed to watch the movie from the shore while the dwarf and the girl watched from the... Where'd the dwarf go? I get why the raft... Somehow the big man got in the raft and it sunk, but why is there a dwarf? And you know what? I'm going to tell you guys this, having read the other ones. This is not the first... This will not be the last time a dwarf shows up in Danny's dreams.
For whatever reason, dwarfs have a tendency to make appearances. They just make things better.
So I swam ashore.
I guess that's why the, what was it? The Avengers? The latest, the one with Thanos. What was it called? Infinity War. That one had a giant dwarf.
Ah, so it's like two for one.
I swam ashore to go join my family again. As I sat back down on the blanket, I had a little panic attack as I felt like I may be late for my game. It then dawned on me that I didn't even know what time the game started. I reached into my backpack in search of the paper with the game schedule on it. After a few moments, I located the paper, looked at where the fourth game of the season was printed on the sheet, and my heart sunk. I had missed the game. It was now 3:30, and the game had started at 1.
How long were you underwater?
Were you under the water? And if I was your family, I would have been super worried.
He just jumped in the water, and he never surfaced.
Well, and they've been waiting for
I'm surprised by the time you got back up from... The water, you know, there weren't like divers going in after your body.
Or I was just like, oh, he goes on little adventures all the time. He'll be fine.
I was so mad because I had now missed 3 out of 4 games and was no longer eligible to win the award for league MVP. That's his worry. I missed 3 out of the 4 games. That kicks me out of the running for league MVP.
It disqualified me because I missed, at that point, too large a percentage of the season to qualify.
As I stood up, head down and frustrated, I woke up.
So wait. What was your team's record at this point?
I think we were 3-0.
So they didn't really need you because you missed two of them already out of the three, and they won. So
yeah, you did.
I don't understand how that puts you at all in the running for MVP
because
the MVP can't miss majority of the games and then they win all those games, right?
I don't know. That's a conundrum. I'm gonna have to rethink my dream. But all I know is I was the best player on our team, and we had the best team because I had assembled a great team. We're going to have a good season, and usually if you have the best record and you're the best player, you're MVP.
Yeah, but you weren't the best player.
You well, didn't show up. How did they know?
I just
There's no way that they – they're like, hey, you know what? We're winning. We don't really need you. Yeah. Why don't you go take a dip in that pond again?
It's sad because I don't know if my team won that day or not. So I don't know if we're 3-1 now or if we're 4-0. Huh. Probably 3-1 because I wasn't there.
Well, like we've talked about this kind of before. I mean, this one sort of has an ending. If you have any ideas for how this story could go on beyond this, feel free to go to our website.
Like
which,
perhaps a loophole that I could become league MVP.
He just really wants to see that he's a league MVP. But go visit our website, which is Daniel.
www.qcodepodcast.com.
And we will have a space there for you to, you know, put in, whether it's a paragraph, a page, whatever, of finishing this story. We'd like to see it, and you know, if it's good enough or makes us laugh or just at least entertains us, we'll probably read it.
Hell, so, we'll even accept if you want to make a little video of how it ends. Any media, like any way you want.
We could post that on the website.
Little cartoons, drawings, whatever.
Turn it into a comic.
Yeah, do that. We can't pay you, but do that. So
your payment,
all ownership of
fame
any
and fortune that you'll receive.
We take ownership of any intellectual property that you put on there.
It becomes ours.
That's successful.
So this is the time of after we read these that we like to kind of psychoanalyze. However, we're going to do something a little different today.
So before we go into like the normal psychoanalysis that Trav's talking about, had an idea from a listener to actually go through.
Hang on.
And
what the hell was
that? It's my voice, all right?
No, you grabbed something off the table.
It was a
hair or something?
Paperclip or something. Was it a paperclip?
No.
Or not a paperclip.
It's a hair. Without looking, he goes back. He takes his hand back and he like does this rubby thing like to drop the hair. And he doesn't notice my dog is right under where he's dropping it. And my dog's just looking up like, what the f-? And he's just dropping crumbs and hair on top of my dog.
I think it's the dog's hair. I'm just returning it to its rightful place. So,
sorry, puppy.
Anyway, yeah. So a listener had the idea of, hey, why don't you go and actually see, like, you can go to like have the dream books or go to like a dream site and try and look up some of the key points of the dream and see what they would have to say about what the meaning of your dream is. So neither Trav or Alan have actually seen this. I went and looked it up myself and just put little descriptions on there. So I'm going to let Trav read them here now, and we'll see kind of what their reaction is to if they think that this is what the dream really means.
Okay. All right. So softball. I guess the mention of a softball or to dream about softball is to stay within your own limits and don't overdo things. I don't know how like that means anything. How does somebody come up with that idea?
That's what I was wondering.
Yeah, you know, I guess you dreamt about softball. Well, that's just because you definitely need to stay within your own limits.
I was going for league MVP.
Because isn't the point of softball and baseball to like hit the ball out of the limits of the field?
Their reasoning is they're saying, look, you're obviously not good enough for baseball. So
just
slow your roll. You're an old man. Just play with the softball.
Next is hunger. Danny was hungry. You know, if you recall, you know, wanting to eat a banana. Hunger signifies a feeling of unfulfillment in some area of his life. So he was hungry. See, but that's the thing. Like, you could have literally been hungry in real life. You're just sleeping, but you're hungry.
I guess and your then mind, I would be unfulfilled.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, you're, the unfulfillment in your life would have been like, dude, there's nothing in my tummy.
I need a sandwich.
Yeah.
I need a banana.
Okay. Which brings us to the next one. Bananas. A metaphor for repressed sexual urges and desires.
What?
Why? Because a banana is phallic shaped. Maybe his mind was just telling him, you know what? You need potassium.
Yeah.
And a gold bracelet.
Or
and some action.
eating bananas. I'm scared to.
And so, yeah, it kind of makes sense that Liz is the one who bought the bananas. That ended up with the gross hemp in it.
Oh. So eating bananas indicate that your hard work will be met with little rewards or gains.
That's the exact opposite of what happened.
I don't see how that really has anything. I feel like if a banana is a metaphor for repressed sexual urges, and eating bananas is that, oh, is it that you like get it? Like you finally get some?
No, I take it as in like, so I'm married, right? And sure. As the classic thing in Bad Boys, the movie says, like, you're married. You get it all the time. He's like, no, man, I'm married. Do you remember that scene?
Yes.
Mike Larry.
Is that the end of the quote?
Maybe because I'm married and I have kids, little kids, I'm very, very, I have a lot of pent up, like, sexual, whatever.
Sexual aggression.
Yeah.
Well, if you can't get it with a voice like that,
I can't even get. It doesn't matter how hard I work, how much like I try to like help take care of the kids and get things done around the house. It'll all go like I will not get the reward at the end of the day. I will just go to bed lonely again. That's how I'm taking it.
Are you saying that's?
But didn't it say
I don't really want to get into this part of your life?
I'm just speculating.
Scared to go down this road.
I didn't know that until I looked it up. But apparently I'm like if I
But if didn't I'm it say eating bananas says. Is a, something about reward?
Well, yeah, indicate that your hard work will be met with little rewards or gains.
Yeah, so I'll work hard, but I won't get a reward.
Or it will be met with little rewards or gains. So it's just little.
Yeah, but like you want a big reward.
Yeah, which is why in his dream, the bananas were full of gold chains and treasure.
Well, here's the next thing. Hair or things in food. Entangled in some emotional matter which you are not sure about how to get out of. So they're just things that you're just like, there is an obstacle here. And I don't know what to do. I don't know how to get this gold chain out of this banana.
Maybe that makes sense. That's why he always dreams about him having the answers. He's the one that people are asking for help. But in real life, he's just a lost soul. I don't know what's going on, guys. I don't have answers.
Well, then they go.
I sure have the answer in this dream. Though,
which is get happened. This 800-pound guy out of the raft.
Well, then they go to a park, which represents temporary escape from reality. A pond represents tranquility. You need some more quiet time to yourself. Dang kids. Also,
that's why I jumped in.
Could mean you
can't. I didn't have to watch the kids.
You're just like, forget you guys.
I was gone so long.
I don't care.
And I missed my game.
There is just some like random person that is asking me to just dive into this pool or into this pond. I'm not going to question it. I'm just going to do it because I need tranquility.
Or when you had this dream, I think it was around the time Aquaman came out. Did you ever go watch Aquaman?
I haven't seen Aquaman.
Oh, okay.
Yet.
If, never mind.
Do you not realize from the last few conversations we've had, this man never watches movies?
I try. Again, I have kids.
Hence this thing, I think from the last, one of the last ones that we recorded, Dreams, he talked about the bird box, which is long over. Like that trend is gone. Movie. So they're watching a movie. Watching a movie suggests that you are watching life pass you by. Oh, you sad sack of garbage. The raft.
You don't think I'm already low enough?
Your dreams are just kicking you in the freaking groin. A raft indicates that you have...
And that's what you would call growing pains.
Can there not be like... How are literally all of these things a negative thing?
That's true. I was wondering. I was like, man, this sucks.
A raft indicates that you have not built a firm foundation for success. There is still much work ahead. Underwater suggests that you are being overcome with emotions and are in over your head regarding some situation, which is, I guess, okay, because in your last dream, or one of the last dreams, you released all of your emotions in letter form.
That's true.
So,
so now I have a new fresh batch ready to go.
This last one, not winning an award symbolizes feelings of inadequacy. He is just the saddest. He is the saddest person, according to this dream, ever. He is a sexually deprived man whose life is going nowhere.
No matter how hard I work,
how hard he tries,
there's gonna be a little reward at the end.
He needs tranquility. He needs tranquility, but honestly, he sinks, just which means that he becomes overcome with all of his emotions. Oh man.
I get inadequate.
I don't ever want feelings. To know. I mean, I don't remember my dreams anyway, but I just feel like wherever you got this was like the most negative.
I got it from like dreammood.com or something like that.
Dream
it was like
mood.
The most robust website I could find on giving you descriptions. I'm surprised that they had all of these words.
I can guarantee you if you went to another website and put in these exact same things, it would be different.
Probably. It's all subjective or?
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's the word.
Subjective,
which is another word for made up.
I just figure this is kind of like Mad Libs.
It's kind of funny though. It's very interesting.
Figure out what it means.
I wonder like if you were sitting down and you were talking to a shrink and you were telling him this and just like they just get this look of fear on their face like, oh my gosh, this man, you should just kill yourself. I'm sorry, that's the only way that this pain that you are in is going to leave. I would never suggest this in any other way. But anyway, well, that's at least better. Because now I don't have to come up with a psychoanalyst. Because, I mean, I don't know. I don't know if I can do any better than that. So
you don't have to psychoanalyze.
I don't have to psychoanalyze anything. But anyway, so there you have it. There is dream number four.
The curious case
of the Bad Batch of Bananas. I told you at the beginning, it really had nothing to do with bananas.
There was like a whole portion on bananas.
I know, but...
And they were bad bananas.
It didn't have anything to do with the actual story. It's just that you were hungry on your way to playing. Some reason, you struck it rich.
I feel like you guys aren't understanding the bananas correctly. How are they bad? First of all...
Well, there's hemp in the first one.
A lot of people love hemp. Gold chain and rings. It's I keep using the word treasure, guys.
No, and that's what I said.
That's not a bad banana. That's freaking
awesome.
I
think that
it's a bad banana if you're hungry and you just want to eat, but it's full of metal.
Take the gold treasure out. And you buy thousands of bananas.
Or just take it out and continue to eat the banana.
Treat it like it's the spoon that you made your cookie dough with or your brownie batter, and you just lick it.
Look,
I
was just trying to get some food because I was on my way to being MVP of the softball league.
I mean, that's like freaking looking, what do they say? Looking a gift horse in the mouth.
Exactly.
I mean, here you're handed something, something precious, something rare, never would happen in ever. And you complain about it.
Yeah. And all you notice That's is true. It's bad teeth.
And you know what? I told you this earlier. This is what I tell my kids. You get what you get and you don't throw a fit. I wouldn't throw a fit if I freaking just was given treasure
in treasure?
A banana. Treasure in a banana.
You got that treasure in the banana.
All right. Next time I get a batch of bananas with treasure in it, I will be grateful.
You should. He's a freaking ungrateful person. That's why you're.
I think
that is
honestly,
why your life sucks.
I might be able. I might be able to explain part of this, like actually from like why I would have this dream about bananas that had things in it that I didn't like, and that I complained about it, and it's because in real life I hate Costco bananas. Like I don't know why, but they are never. Very good. There's always something just off.
It's because
about
you have to let them ripen.
You do. You can't.
The Costco purposely sells them green.
You can't so just eat them green, Dan.
You have to let them sit for a few days on the counter.
I know. I'm just saying. I know, and I wait for them to turn yellow, and they're still not. There's something wrong with.
Honestly,
them.
The best ones are like when they're almost basically brown and mushy.
Maybe. Again, I've tried them at every color stage, and they're never good.
I just have to say one more thing. Danny, he's like, if he were a girl, he would not be a romantic. Because you know how like people sometimes propose by putting a ring in like a dessert or like the bottom of a champagne bottle or like, champagne glass?
Ew.
Danny would be like, hey, just get it and be like, God damn it! Stupid ring with a diamond.
Ew.
It changed the way this wine tastes.
I can never I can never wear this because it's been in my meatloaf. Anyway, well, that's it for dream number four. Be sure to, like I said, go visit our website, comment on all of our social medias. I'll tell you those later.
They'll probably be posted on our website.
Be posted on our website.
And we'll tell you on all of our regular episodes.
Yes.
Not our bonus episodes.
But thank you for listening, and we'll see you next time.